Welcome to my channel. I'm Zhang Jingxu. Let's look at the problem 15 in chapter 8. Chapter 8 is about the conservation of energy. As we can see, there is a person do the bungee jumper, right? At the start, the person is there. Then he or she fall down and reaches to zero, 12 meters below. At this time, the bungee is extend. So from there to this one, there is a distance for the bunch, right? And this one brings the elastic energy. Do you agree? And for this work, we can see, we know the gravity do the work, and also the elastic force do the work. Do you agree? Yes. So both the force is conserved, so make the mechanic energy is conserved. So in this one, first thing we need to find the spring constant. So how can we do that? We consider the initial state and the final state, the energy is conserved. The initial state velocity V1 0, Y1 is 31 meter. We take the final as a reference point. The X1, the extension for the bunch is 0, agree? Yes, and then at the final state, the V2 is 0, velocity 0, and the Y2 is 0. The extension for the bungee is 19 meters, because from there, the bungee starts to extend, and finally it reaches to there, it is 19 meters. So in this one, the energy is conserved. The initial energy equals to final energy, so we can say the initial kinetic energy plus gravitational potential energy plus elastic energy equals the final kinetic energy plus the potential energy, gravitational potential energy plus the final elastic energy. Agree? Then we can input the known quantities. V1 is 0, make this term 0. And the X1 is 0, make this term 0. And the V2 is 0, 0. And the Y2 is 0. Finally, only these two terms survive. And then very easily we can find this key. Right? Very easy. And you can see it's 2mg y1 divided by x2 squared. And the m mass is given. y1 is given there. x2 is given. So very easily for you to find the key. The next, the problem B, ask you to find the maximum acceleration she experienced. So the maximum acceleration, that means the net force is maximum. Agree? So we can see the gravity is always constant. So how can the net force become maximum? That means the elastic force is maximum. It comes to this position, right? Elastic force is key x2 minus the gravity, because the gravity always pointing down, and then elastic force up to hold the person, right? Key x2. So now the net force is Ks2 minus the gravity equals the mass times acceleration. This comes from Newton's second law. In this equation, we can find acceleration A. And we can see K is known, K is given, X2 is given, mass is given, G is a constant. Then you can find A. Now we can input the known quantities. We find the K is around 93 Newton per meter. And then the acceleration is around 22 meters per second squared. Thank you.